Members of Ifimes, ladies and gentlemen, dear friends, thank you all for coming and welcome. International Institute for Middle East and Balkan Studies, Ifimes from Ljubljana, as organizer of today's event, is honored to welcome distinguished guest, His Excellency Zoran Zaev, Prime Minister of the Republic of North Macedonia. His Excellency Zoran Zaev is Prime Minister of the Republic of North Macedonia since 31st May 2017. He is also the President of the Social Democratic Union of Macedonia, SDSM. He is part of the new generation of politicians on the Macedonian political scene. He is one of the most recognizable social democratic politicians and the younger generation in the region. His efforts are directed towards the membership of the Republic of North Macedonia in the European Union and NATO, to the fight against crime and corruption, and to the economic development of his country. The Republic of North Macedonia has become a positive example to other countries in the region and a lighthouse of Euro-Atlantic integrations. Some called it as a success story. Last year, in May, our guest was leader of the opposition and president of VMRO, DPMNE, Dr. Christian Mickovski, who had an excellent lecture. We will invite him again because we considered it important to hear different opinions from the authorities and the opposition, not only in North Macedonia, but also in other countries of the region, so that political and social dialogue is established. In his lecture, President Zoran Zaev will talk about current developments in North Macedonia since coming to power, setting a date for the start of negotiations with the European Union and the future of North Macedonia, which is linked to regional and neighborly cooperation and membership in the European Union and NATO. Почитувани премиер Зоран Заев, ваши екселенции, членови на Советот, Советодавниот одбор и членови на Меѓународниот институт Ифимес, дами и господа, почитувани учесници на денешното предавање и сите други кои не следат преко интернет, дозволете ми најпрво да ве поздравим и да ви се заблагодарам што во толку број се одазвате на денешното предавање на председател на владата на Република Северна Македонија, господинот Зоран Заев, на тема Република Северна Македонија приказна за успехот. Денешниот настан очигледно кажува дека и ние се едно за тоа што се случува во Северна Македонија и во регионот. Почитуван премиер Заев, добро дојдовте во Ифимес и во Словенија. Минатата година, во месец мај, наш гостин беше председателот на ВМРО-ДПМНЕ Христијан Мицковски, кој имаше одлично предавање. Него потворно ке го повикаме, бидејќи сметаме дека е важно во Северна Македонија, но во и другите држави од регионот, да слушаме различни мишленја и на власт и на опозицијата и да се воспостави политички и обштествен диалог. За жал сме лимитирани со знање на македонски јазик и овај настан бомо продолжимо на англашки јазик. Имамо ше у словенчини. Споштувани господ премиер Зоран Заев, ваша екселенце, члани света, светувалнег одбора, члани Меднародниг института Ифимес, дами и господе, доволите ми да вас најпре поздравим и захвалим да сте се одзвали у толичнем повабилу на денашни догодек, предавање негове екселенце Зорана Заева, председника владе Републике Северне Македоније. Шенкрат, споштувани премиер, добро дошли на Ифимес. Негова екселенца Зоран Заев е председник владе Републике Северне Македонија од 31. маја лета 2017, председник е ту Социјалдемократски звезе Македонија. Соди у генерацијо, ново генерацијо млајших политика на македонски политични сцени е еден од најбоље препознавних социјалдемократски политика млајши генерацији у регији. Негова призадевања су смерена к членству негове државе во ЕУ НАТО и боју против криминалу, корупцији, тер економскиму развоју негове државе. Република Северна Македонија постала позитивен пример другим државам у регији и светилник евроатлантски интеграцију, кој ја именуваа тут згодба успеху. Лани во мају е наш гост био туди водја opozicije in predsednik VMRO DPMNE, dr. Hristijan Mickovski, ki ima odlično predavanje, spet ga bomo povabili, ker menimo, da je pomembno, da slišimo različna mnenja oblasti in opozicije, ne samo v Severni Makedoniji, ampak tudi v drugih državah v regiji, saj se tako vzpostavlja politični in socialni dialog. Na predavanju bo premijer Zaev govoril o aktualnih dogajanju v Severni Makedoniji od prihoda na oblast, o določitvi datuma začetek pogajanja za Evropsko unijo in prihodnosti Severne Makedonije, ki je povezana z regionalnim in sosedskim sodelovanjem in s članstvom Evropske unije in NATO. Your Excellency, the floor is yours.
Dear friends, thank you very much. Dragi prijatelji od Makedonije, što ve gledam ovde, dobar den na site. It's great honor for me to be here in our friendly country, Slovenia, in the capital of Ljubljana, having occasion through our friend institute, Ifimes, to have possibility to talk with distinguished members of Slovenian society for what's happened in North Macedonia, what is the new things, what make us very proud, really, after few years, and what is the hope for future of this small country, very equal like Slovenia, which built good friendship with Slovenian citizens since ex-Yugoslavia, but to coming days, really. And it's great to be here. We are here mainly for official state visit in Slovenia. We have meetings with the president of the country, with the president of the parliament and the prime minister. We have a lot of to work together because we want to increase our cooperation in a variety of ways, especially in economy, but also culturally, in social aspect, medicine aspect, and other ways of interest of our citizens of both countries. So, first of all, I want to thanks to Ifimes because it's a symbol of democracy to the whole region. I want to encourage you to be very strong in the future, very loud, talk about the weak part of the countries, talk about the advantages of the countries, because really the Balkan will become a better place, part of European Union, of course, and part of normal democratic world, pro-Western oriented for sure, because the whole Balkan have only one way for the future, that is way what bring us to be equal with the Western European countries in every kind of way of living of our citizens. I was here guest of Ifimes 2 years and maybe more. I am the Prime Minister of the North Macedonia few days after today, 2 years I will finish. So for me, it's very, very good to talk about a lot of changes, what's happened in this small country in the heart of the Balkan during all these 2 years. It's not only because I'm Prime Minister, I lead this government, probably both of us parties like opposition and the government parties learn from the political crisis what our country and our citizens must pass through. A few years ago, we have very big political crisis. Our country was determined and confirmed like a capture state, like hybrid regime, and of course we passed through very dramatic period of time with a lot of negotiation, but a lot of change happened in our country with a vote and with a pencil, and we are very proud of that because during the dramatic period of time, we try through the dialogue, through the negotiation, to find a way of escaping of difficult situation for the country and for the citizens, and to implement it very good road for the future of this small country and for our citizens in North Macedonia. So 2 years ago, we have one very tough and hard period of time when the majority in the parliament was attacked by the violent citizens who tried to stop the process of transforming the government power from the existing government to the existing opposition, because we preserve majority in the parliament. In 27 of April, we choose a new president of the parliament, and that was the time when we choose first time Albanian citizens for a president of the country, so citizens from Albanian minority in the country. Our existing president of the parliament, Mr. Tala Jeferi. And it's happened really bad event when the doors of the parliament was open and near to 4,000 citizens using a violence, most of them, tried to kill us, to take lives. And there was pictures all around the world what's happened during all these 2 hours. But of course, we passed through this very dramatic period of time for the citizens and for the country. And of course, we implemented the government in 31st of May by voting in the parliament. And of course, a lot of things starting to change from this period of time. In the meantime, we became a really society and the country, what everybody talked for us with a positive words, with a positive example, because we built the concept of one society for all, where all citizens from all different ethnical groups are together with obligation to have equal rights and equal obligation. And we're continuing to build this concept, one society for all, because it's our advantage. We are a multi-ethnic country, where near to 65% are Macedonian citizens, more than 20% are Albanian citizens, and the rest of 15% are Turks, Serbs, Bosniaks, Romans, and other minorities in the country who live together, not since last decades, but centuries ago, and we want to improve the whole quality of life for everybody in the country. We solve the decade existing problem with Bulgaria, signing the new agreement of friendship, good neighborhood relations, and cooperation. And this agreement was the first symbol of building a friendship in the Balkan. And I'm very proud and I'm very grateful of my colleague Boyko Borisov from Bulgarian government, who is the Prime Minister of Bulgaria, because we together achieved this famous agreement, what parallelly encouraged me to continuing in this direction, and we find a way, even solution for three decade existing problem with Greece. Of course, the problem what stopped this country for the integration process in NATO and European Union, and we are very proud of that. We have a role model of the agreement what can be used in other regions in the world level for a solution, solutions for identity, solution how to build a friendship, and solution how to open perspective for the young and next generation of people of the countries. So the agreement gives solution how to recognize our Macedonians with Greek Macedonians and build a friendship and future. Of course, make a distinction with geographical distinction for the new name of our country, because we are really north part of the historical region Macedonia, who cover also part of Greece, part of Bulgaria, and even small part of Albania. But this agreement show the huge courage of the politicians to take responsibility, no matter what will happen with own careers, but also to bring possibility for preserving a future for the young generation and to serve to the citizens and to the countries, no matter what will happen with the political careers. Of course, this agreement give us opportunity, first of all, finally to become a friend with our first neighbor, Greece, who is our south neighbor, and give opportunity to have first ever official visit of Greek Prime Minister in Skopje, in North Macedonia. And that was happened a few months ago, or month and a half ago, when we have government-to-government session. We sign a lot of agreement. We have a meeting with the businessmen, because with the Prime Minister Tsipras arrived in Skopje, more than 200 businessmen from more than 140 companies. And that was really big event and opened a huge opportunity between two countries. Parallelly, of course, we receive a lot of awards all around the Europe, from Austria, from Germany. Now we have a new award from Great Britain, a non-government organization. And of course, we are even nominated for Nobel Prize. But even nomination, it's a huge honor for us because we are a small country. It's a great opportunity for us really to introduce our country, North Macedonia, but also Greece, in a positive light, because we want to build friendship and we want to improve the quality of life of our citizens. But parallelly, it's happened a lot of positive things inside of the country. Of course, all these agreements, what we achieve, put us to be the unique country in the Western Balkan without open bilateral issue. So we are friends with everybody, and everybody are friends with us. That give a lot of opportunity for cooperation. Results are excellent. The public administration was encouraged and motivated very high to implement it a lot of reforms. We finish the first and second stage of reforms in our country, and in the moment, we are country, beside all this agreement, we fulfill 100% of reform process in our country, and we continuing in this direction to finalize other aspects what will improve the quality of life. By the way, parallelly with all these agreements and all these reforms, we open all windows and all doors for our country, especially for integration process. We are next member country of NATO, and we will be 30th member country of NATO, I hope, in December. The process of ratification is ongoing. 13 member countries ratified the protocol. The Slovenia was the first country who ratified the protocol, and after Greece, and we are very happy because Slovenia is one of the biggest friends of North Macedonia. And having that in mind, we're continuing in this direction, and we hope that the rest of the countries, the 16 countries, will ratify the protocol during the summer, during the autumn. So if it's possible, we intend to achieve the full membership ceremony in London in December, in the beginning of December, in the next NATO summit, what will be in Great Britain. So in this direction, parallelly, we move in the European Union integration. I hope that we will get it. A decision for starting of negotiation with the European Union after 14 years waiting in front of European doors like candidate country, and we wait so long period of time because of all these problems what we have it with our neighbors, mainly with Greece. Of course, the report of European Union will be announced in Wednesday this week, and we hope for the excellent report, because we fulfill all reforms, what was projected for us, and we are really positive example for everybody. We show European manner, European behavior. Everybody talk about Prespa agreement, everybody talk about what's happened in North Macedonia. We are very happy, and we are also appreciate very much the dialogue what we have with the opposition. The last goal was achieved, the last goal was to vote together in the parliament the new law for security and intelligence services. We vote in the parliament with the consensus, all together, all political stakeholders, and we're continuing in this direction. But parallelly of all this achievement, normally economic results come. So we make all these solutions and agreement. We do all these reforms with hope that we will improve the economic quality of life of our citizens. And the results are really the best. The new records was breakdown in the country. So we finished 2018 with a new record of foreign direct investment, what was 625 million euro, and is double than the best year in the past was 2011. We have 340 million euro. The GDP was increased 5.5%. -1.8 was before 2 years ago when I became a prime minister because of recession and all this political crisis. We ended 2018 with 3.7% in the last quarter. And also we expected now our statistic to announce the the data for the last quarter of GDP, and we expect bigger than 4% increasing of our domestic production. Also, we decrease unemployment in the country from 27% to 19.4%, that is 7.5% less. We increase the salary of the country, average salary increased 6.6%. We increase our export 16.5%. We increase our industrial production 8.8%. So the numbers are very beautiful and very encouraging. What show that is worthful to be a positive example, to build a friendship with the neighbors, and also to make reforms in the country. Parallelly, of course, we continuing to work for the future. The last election was very successful in our country. We have a new president, the president Stevo Pendarovski, start his obligation in 12th of May this year. Our election finish in 5th of May. We achieve, of course, this 40% of census of our country, and we are very proud because all different ethnical groups and all different religion groups and all different cultural groups in our country stand behind of this candidate, what is now the new president of the country. Since the beginning of nomination, they was supporting him, and of course, now the president have obligation to be equal president for every citizens, no matter which ethnical group the citizens are or in which religion they believe. That is the new value of what's happened in our country, and of course we continuing to be positive example for the future. In the moment, of course, we are focused for the decision of European Union. Election was finished yesterday. I wish all the best to all European countries, but we will wait everything what will happen in the new European Commission, of course, for further support of integration process of the Western Balkan in the European Union, what is very important for us, like citizens of North Macedonia, but also for the all countries who are candidate countries and who intend to be member countries of the European Union. I believe very much that this small country, equal like Slovenia, will use the best examples also from Slovenia, because Slovenia always with unselfish share all positive things with us, and even mistake they share with us. But also we hope that we can give opportunity to Slovenia also to learn some positive things also from North Macedonia. So we are the country with a new name normally, but we are very proud because we keep identity of our citizens, and now we have confirmation of the identity of the biggest community in our of our country, that is Macedonians. Before that, we doesn't have that kind of recognition. Nobody now make us a problem of our identity, nor nobody make us a problem for our official language. We are country what is confirmed by the rest of the world, and of course we have all hope for the better future of our citizens. I believe that we will continue to be good example. That means that we will try to find always solution with a dialogue, not only with opposition, with neighbors, with the European Union, with the rest of the world, but especially at home. We will prepare more and more European regulation in our country to be really by regulation also European country, and we hope that we will stop the migration of our citizens who leave the country, and I hope also that we will provoke them to bring back in the country. Subia is here, and a lot of our friends are here. I hope that they will not spend only third or half of the time in North Macedonia. They will be back completely sometimes in North Macedonia, because really the home is only one, and we have now a global village. The world is global village. We can manage our job and our work all around the world, but it's good to live at home together with the families, and of course to wait grandchildren at home. I use this opportunity to send a message for future cooperation. I want to share with you that all these results, what we achieve with our friends. One of our friends are Ifimes, and I want to recognize that and to confirm, because during the difficult period of time when I negotiate together with Minister Dimitrov, and when I talk with our institution how to improve the capacity of institution, I have help from this very respected institute in the southeastern Europe especially, but even higher. But our friends, like Rico, help us economically, sharing with us. Bartul is here, who was the chief of the offices of NATO in our country. You know that the ambassador for European Union in North Macedonia is from Slovenia, Mr. Zbogar, and Ambassador Jazbec is always with us, official Slovenian ambassador in our country, and a lot of other friends who work in our country from Slovenia. I want to thank all of you, because of you also we are better country now, and of course to be prepared to be even better friends to you. So I want to continue this cooperation. We will work with the Prime Minister Šarec how to improve possibility and conditions to increase cooperation in variety of fields, especially in economy. There is a few projects what we prepare even to start it since next autumn, and I believe that that will tight even more the relations between Slovenians and Macedonians. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Mr. Prime Minister. Thank you for compliments. I would like to ask Mr. Aljaf, starting with discussion.
Thank you, Zijad. How do you, Mr. Prime Minister, manage to have good relations with all neighbors? Your procedure, Gruevski, did not succeed in that. You mentioned just before, but now some details about that, and what is the secret of this success?
I think a positive character, always optimist, is very helpful. I never stop to be optimist, because optimism really gives sometimes solution when you believe that it's not possible to find solution. Of course, to build friendship, I check it that at home. When I build friendship with my wife, there is good future of family. So I implemented that also in the state level. But you really know that building friendship always bring results. And that kind of decisions what we make was not very easier, because when we signed the agreement with Greece, only 17% was supportive for the solution. 17% was supportive for the solution. We take the risk no matter what will happen with the political career and the politicians who make this decision. We believe very much that through this agreement we will be very helpful for our citizens and for our countries. I appreciate that also to Prime Minister Tsipras, but also now after 11 months of signing this agreement, 70% support the solution of this agreement, what show also that the citizens follow the leaders who have enough courage to make agreement. Of course, Prime Minister Gruevski doesn't help us. He even make up more problems for us. He try and he success to escape from the country. Not only we want to bring him back in the country, because he has a final penalty from the court. The court process was completely monitored by the European Union member countries, really. And we promise that the justice will come for everybody, no matter what was the name and which party. Everybody have responsibility in front of the court, and the law must be equal for everybody. But of course, I appreciate very much that our citizens have enough strength to continuing in the right direction. And today we are really very, very hopeful country for our citizens, and we believe that the results will be even better, because we are with that kind of positive results. Even we are not full member of NATO, even we don't have still decision of European Union, and that is very hopeful that will be happen, and after that the results will be even better.
In connection with this question, it's interesting that until now, nor has the Prime Minister nor the President of Northern Macedonia visited Greece. Prime Minister Tsipras visited your country, as you mentioned, in April, early April, I think. When can we expect you in Athens?
The intention was to visit Athens in end of August or beginning of September. Of course, we wait everything to stabilize after yesterday election. Yesterday election was not very comfortable for my friend Alexis. Of course, maybe he expect that, but he announced early election now in Greece because of the results. Of course, when the Greece will be prepared, I will be very happy to visit Athena and to continuing the dialogue. I'm very happy because the opposition from Greece is very aware and supportive from agreement. Normally, we need to continuing like citizens, like countries, and of course, our opposition also in North Macedonia is aware of this agreement, and this agreement built friendship between two neighboring countries, what will bring only benefits for the both countries.
My another question is regarding the region. Lately, the exchange of territories is an actual topic. You say that you support any agreement between Belgrade and Pristina, which is not at the expense of third parties. How do you look at all these big state projects which are in the air in the region?
Every solution of the problematic situation in the region is very helpful for the other countries, not only for those countries who have a problem. Kosovo issue is the second or the next issue what the Balkan need solution. So I hope that the President Vučić and President Tači will continue in dialogue. Through the dialogue, it's only possible to find solution. I want to encourage them to continue in this direction because only through the dialogue, through the diplomacy, they can preserve a good future for their own citizens and own countries, normally. Changing of territory for us is not acceptable. Why? Because we believe, all of us, that someday we will be member country of European Union. And that means that we will open our borders. Why to put another borders now or even change the borders? Europe is multi-ethnical, very different. We like Balkan are multi-ethnical and very different in ethnicity. And I believe that it's not good to talk about changing borders because ethnical borders are not solution. It's not possible even to do it, ethnical borders. Always somebody is out of the borders. So who cares? Let's open our borders. Let's cooperate and bring the better economic condition for our citizens. I don't want to make problems for those who negotiate because I know how good it is to be helpful to go to those who negotiate. And I honestly want to share with them my experience. Even the citizens have reserve if they believe that some kind of solution will bring the good future of own country and own citizens, I encourage them to continue. Citizens will follow them. So the solution what will bring stability of the region, solution what will be good hope for the Serbians and for Kosovars and the other ethnical groups, it's a good solution. This solution must preserve eternal peace in the region and better regional cooperation, for sure, and finally, European integration.
All countries in the region have problems with economic reconstruction. Most countries have weaker economic indicators than before the collapse of the former common state Yugoslavia. What's the problem of the economic reconstruction of the region, including your state of Northern Macedonia?
No, all of us do a lot of reforms, especially economic reforms. But probably we must change our mind because we believe that still is possible to leave these socialistic methods from ex-Yugoslavia. That is ended. We are democratic countries, we are capitalistic countries, and we must be focused how to work better, to earn more money, and to really appreciate the work what we have it. And I believe very much that open doors for the European experiences in our country must be as quick as possible to open our markets and to strengthen our economy to be more competitive, to use our resources, to use our qualified workforce and very good people who are good symbol for good working people. That is our advantages. Normally, geographical position is always our good advantages, and I believe very much that we will be more and more attractive for the foreign investors. In our country, as I mentioned it, we break new records, really. We have a new records of foreign direct investment. This year, I expect even better results than the last year, and I believe very much that through preparing of better economic reforms in the countries, there will be better economic results for our citizens.
The practice is that political parties in the country that wants to become a member of the European Union support its European path. How is in Northern Macedonia regarding opposition?
All our parties who are also parliamentarian parties are supportive for European and NATO integration. So in the moment, more than 75% of our citizens are in favor of NATO and European Union integration. It's a big percent, really, and we are happy and we want to keep it this percent. It's possible to keep it if the citizens feel benefits and results of our integration process. Opposition is also officially in favor of integration of NATO and European Union. Practically, they are not so visible connecting with that, because during all this process, during all this agreement, they was not very helpful. But of course, I continuing to be optimist, and I believe very much that we must move in this direction, especially through the dialogue, through finding solution, both sides, government and opposition, because that is the easiest and the best way to serve to our citizens.
Beginning of this month, May, you were in Sarajevo at the annual European Bank EBRD assembly. Often Bosnia Herzegovina is compared with your country for its multi-ethnic. How do you see the situation in Bosnia Herzegovina, and do you see the solution?
No, the solution mainly depend from domestic politicians. Domestic politicians must be more responsible for the citizens. I know that every politician wants to keep his position, to remain as long as possible, but if through that it's a damage for the future of the country and the future of the citizens, you know, in the end of the day, it's not worthful. So my encouragement is to politicians who represent different ethnical groups in Bosnia-Herzegovina, they must take care of each other. So I hope that the Bosnian politicians will take care for Serbs and Croats. Also, the Serbs will take care for Bosnians and Croats. Also, I believe that in this direction they can preserve better functioning institution and, of course, to put the country in a more pleasant situation than now. We show that through examples. In my country, I'm very proud that I'm one of the politicians who get votes and support not only from Macedonians. I get vote and support from Albanians, from Bosniaks, from Serbs, from Turkish nationality, from Romans, from everybody in the country. And of course, there is Albanians who get support from everybody, and even Bosniaks get support from everybody. That is the value, because there is a good and bad people. It's not good and bad ethnical groups. Everybody have the same problem, everybody have the same goals, and we need to work together if we want to be helpful to each other.
Yesterday we have the elections for the European Parliament. How do you see the results of these elections?
The results are confirmation of the expectation of the citizens. Normally it's democracy. For us, it's very hopeful, because it's less nationalism than we expected through the all political parties who get seats in the European Parliament. EPP, Social and Democrats, ALTE group are very good represented, but also Greens, are very good represented in the parliament. All of that is very hopeful for the future of Europe, and after that is very hopeful for us who want to be part of European Union. So I believe that the new European Commission will be prepared in a way how to reform Europe, to be better, to have better Europe, but also we are here also to help this process like candidate country. We don't intend to be immediately member country. Our intention is to get a chance to start negotiation and open chapters. We are very aware that after 2025, even after that, we will be a member country. But parallelly, we can be very helpful. I think North Macedonia, through these all best examples, even now, is very helpful to the European Union. But my comments are positive for future of European Union, especially after the results of yesterday election. And I believe that the leaders of Europe will continuing to be leaders of Europe, not only leaders of the own nation, because they have obligation also to be leaders of the whole European Union.
Northern Macedonia belongs to the very top of the countries, among the first three countries in the world, I think, according to the percentage of the diaspora, which is over 40%. What is the message of the state or of the government to the diaspora?
Maybe
you answered before in your...
Yes, I answered it. Our hope that we will prepare our own country, our gather country, to be good enough for them to bring them back. That is our hope. They are our motor power, and we lose them. Why? Because they try to find better conditions for life, for own self, but also for own children. I'm very aware of that. And they will be back, for sure, if they find good chance at home. So we work very hard to preserve this good chance, and we need help from them to make it that quicker. They can help us sharing experience, what they bring from the existing country when they are back at home, but also they are one of the biggest investors in our country. So opening some small factories and some small storage to buy lands, etc., etc., they help also our economic condition in the country. So I believe very much that the migration from our country and from the all countries from Southeastern Europe will stop it. And of course, the citizens who live abroad will, part by part, starting to come back at home.
What was the most difficult moment for you in the past 2 years as the Prime Minister of the Republic of Northern Macedonia?
There was a few difficult moments during the past, but of course, the most difficult period of time was how to fight against regime who control everything, without losing blood or lives of citizens. And we succeed. We are very proud because we break down the regime in our country with pencil and our right of vote. And of course, that confirms once again the capacity of the citizens of North Macedonia and give a guarantee for the good future of the North Macedonia.
How did you feel the official nomination for the Nobel Prize, Peace Prize, together with Greek Prime Minister Alexis Tsipras?
For me, it's a good occasion for introduction of my country. We are a small country, and we try to find a way how to introduce this positive country in a good geographical position, with a very good citizens inside, to the rest of the world. Of course, that will help us to attract investors in our country, to talk for us in a positive way, and that is my big prize, what we get it even through the nomination.
And finally, what's the message from today's lecture?
The message is like conclusion.
Yes.
The message is, let's continuing to build friendship inside of the countries, out of the countries. That will be very helpful for our European continent, for sure, because the European continent is still the more powerful continent in the world, and we need to continue in this direction. This is the continent with the biggest democratic rights and freedoms. Let's continue to be in the first place in the world. And of course, let's be more inventive, more courage, because through the courage and invention and the decisions, we can move our continent and our world together.
Thank you very much. Zijad, please.
Here. I would like to thank Mr. Prime Minister, Mr. Zoran Zaev, for his interesting lecture, which will help us to understand better the current situation in North Macedonia and also the future of this country and the region as a whole. We wish your country all the best, and to you, we wish you to receive the Nobel Prize, Peace Prize, together with Prime Minister Tsipras.
By the way, how much money they give?